macular degeneration, like what about that really caught your interest?
Well, it is the most common cause of blindness in aging populations. Number one cause of blindness in the US above the age of 55 and number three globally. So we're talking about 11 to 15 million patients in the US as we speak.
So what are you researching right now?
So I am particularly interested about how the diet can affect our gut microbiome, which is the trillions of the microbes that live in our gut, and how that can affect your risk to develop macular degeneration or your risk to develop advanced forms and go blind. Microbiome is such a fascinating organ at this point. We realize it's not just these microbes that are sitting there, they just like happen to sit there, but actually have a very important role for our health and several disease states. And a lot of attention has been brought the last like decade. And now we know that it's actually the way the environment, our lifestyle is talking to our body. These microbes control significant functions, both locally at our like our gastrointestinal tract, but also distant organs like the brain, the heart, the immune system throughout the body, psychiatric disorders. And more recently, as me and some other colleagues discover and present in the eyes as well.
Fascinating. How is Bright Focus helping you with your research?
Bright Focus has been instrumental in our program. It started as a kind of like, as we call, high risk, high reward idea, that there was not much in the literature. And on first look, it looks kind of like far-fetched, like how does the gut and what happens to your gut affects what happens to your eyes. But Bright Focus really, it was really instrumental, and it trusted my team and myself to kind of put together really specialist and collaborative efforts to really try to address these questions and maybe connect the missing dots in macular degeneration and find the missing links. And, you know, being at the University of Chicago, I could not again do any of these because it doesn't take only the grant, but you need great collaborators, people who believe in crazy ideas. So I need to give a big thank you also to my collaborator, Professor Jin Chang, who's a very famous microbiome scientist specializing in Crohn's disease.
So what are you learning?
Just the diet alone can change the microbiome, and the microbiome can directly affect very important gene functions in the retina and inflammation level, and that can affect the phenotype and the manifestation of MIMD. And to me, that was like mind-blowing. It was an observation I had done 10 years ago. I was in the lab when I was a PhD student. Back then, I did not know about microbiome, and now I have an answer why I give my mice half a diet, why they get more macular degeneration. In general, whatever is good for the heart and for the brain is good for the eyes as well. Plant-based diets, avoid processed foods, try to avoid foods that may have a lot of chemicals or pesticides or antibiotics because they can really disturb the microbiome. So eat healthy, plant-based diet. And, you know, I know there's a lot of interest with pharmaceuticals, but what if we like find something, if you eat 2 tablespoons of olive oil a day, it can decrease your risk of macular degeneration by 10% when you're like 70 years old. It could be something as simple as that, but we need to do the research to find out. Diet is not just a lifestyle habit. Diet is medicine, and diet is what we give to our body. And if you treat your body well with good diet, I think your body will do well as well.